My name is Alexey Kalinin, and I am a game developer and co-founder of a small indie game studio. It's called FIFTYTWO. We're based in Nizhny Novgorod, Russia. FIFTYTWO is a small studio. I work with my two friends. We met in a software company in 2012. We started our own company, and we already released three games. The first one was Jellies, the second one was Kensho, and the last one, Populus Run. Populus Run, it's an unusual running game where you control a crowd of people. The goal is simple, get as many as you can to the finish line, at least one. Each level you need to avoid high-calorie foods, collect coins and secret characters. Secret characters, it's like fresh, healthy food, like broccoli, tomato. Also, we have battle rapper bosses in the game. This is a big donut, big burger and macaron. In a nutshell, it's a fun, quite hardcore game. Every single 3D object in Populus Run was made with Houdini. I made a lot of assets for the game, including a character generator, a level editor, a bunch of different generators of foods, buildings, cars, trees and more. Actually, I started to learn Houdini when I realized that I want to make as many runners as I can, and I want to make them very different, like it's man, woman, child, big, small, and very different. And with other software, it's a very difficult problem to solve, actually. Then I started to build this character generator. I make a main character, tune a bit some parameters, variation parameters, then click generate, and I have a lot of different variations of this character. It works through the PDG, and PDG makes the most work for me. One more example, I have a building generator, and the same, I set up the main model, I change window style, floor height and width, and after that I can generate buildings looks like this building, but a bit different. This is the main thing I think I've done for Populus Run, is a level generator. This is a asset I can use right in Unity. It looks like I draw one curve, and the road is creating along this curve. In the game we have different parts of the level. We have pipes and roads, and I can set up these parts. A road contains a few layers, and I can control each layer and the shape of this layer. And I could use it to make a different style of the road for different chapters, for example. The second asset I made is to control each level of the road. With this asset I can make that the road will look like an off-road or stadium or as a city, very different. Also, one huge asset and the most powerful tool I made for the game is a scattering tool. I use it for scattering prefabs and 3D models along these tracks I made. I can choose where I want to scatter on and what actually to scatter. It could be stones, trees or fences to make a level looks unique. Yeah, Houdini very important in my workflow. Because you know, it's very important to me to have a chance to change everything, to control every aspect of the game. When I, for example, when I learn something new, I want to implement this into my workflow as soon as possible. And Houdini helps me a lot with my wishes. When you work in Houdini a lot, you start thinking about everything another way. I mean, it's not only about 3D, it's about actually your life. You want to make everything around you faster, and you don't want to make repeatable things every day. You want to make everything procedural.